Hey bakers, welcome back to my channel. I'm Angela from Bake Angel and we're going to do something a little different today. Now you know that I like experimenting with recipes and finding ways to make them allergy safe. So today I wanted to talk to you about the differences when you use egg and egg substitutes in recipes. So you can see here that I've got three different types of cupcakes and can you guess what I used in each of them as the egg substitute, or did I in fact use egg in any of them? Let's have a look at the first one. Now you can see straight away there's a difference in color and a difference in fullness to these cupcakes as well. So let me explain to you what I did for this experiment. I used the same base cupcake recipe with equal quantities of self-raising flour, sugar, and plant-based butter. I also added a little bit of vanilla and a little bit of baking powder to them as well. Now let's have a look at them side by side. So the one on the left is quite brown on top. The crumb looks fairly soft too. It's got a little bit of springiness to it, but also looks a little dense and a lot shorter than the other ones. The second one is really light and fluffy, as you can see on the top when I pick it up. And the third one, well, that one is just the biggest of all of them. Now we're gonna cut them up and have a closer look at the crumb inside. And I'll also explain which is which here as well. So the first one, I actually used 100 grams of applesauce for this batch of cupcakes. You can see that crumb is quite tight. There are some holes in it, so it is a little bit soft. But still, it is not as full as we would like for our cupcakes. The second one, I actually used buttermilk. So I used a half cup of plant-based milk with half a tablespoon of white vinegar. And that was my egg substitute. And you can see that one is really light just because when you use buttermilk in recipes, it tends not to brown as much. And the third one, well, I'll confess to you, that's the batch that I actually used the eggs in. Look at the difference, isn't it incredible? I mean, all three of these cupcakes taste amazing in their own different way, but it's a really interesting experiment to see the difference if you are wanting to make substitutions to your recipes. So now let's just do one final check and measure them. So when you put the halves on top, you can see the applesauce one is 2 inches, the buttermilk one is 2.5 inches, and the winner here, if you're looking for height, is definitely the eggs with 3 inches. So again, as I say, if you want your cakes to look a certain way and you want to play around with substitutions, this is a great visual to show you the differences. Now, of course, there are other egg substitutes that you can use in your baking as well. My go-to is usually the applesauce because we have a lot of that in the house, but I do tend to use buttermilk in my large cakes because I find that it just adds a little bit of an extra pop of flavor, which is really good. And of course, if you like using eggs, they're always going to work well for you as well. I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. Watch out for more baking science videos coming up on my channel soon. Make sure you check out this recipe for my dairy-free cupcakes and this one for my vegan cupcake recipe. Thanks for watching.